On today's episode, are you an engineering whistleblower? Today's episode is brought to you by engineering.com, a globally trusted source for engineering content. Check out this and many other exclusive videos for the engineering professional found only on engineering.com TV today. Is honesty always the best policy? Well, almost always it is. And if you're former Hyundai engineer Kim Gwang-ho, it's lucrative too. Kim has just been awarded $24 million by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration under the agency's new whistleblower program. In 2016, Kim told NHTSA that Hyundai had failed to correct an engine issue that was causing power plant seizures and fires, and provided the agency with evidence that resulted in the company paying $210 million in penalties over the issue. Eventually, Hyundai and Kia recalled 1.6 million vehicles to address this issue. So what is this whistleblower program? Well, it's a little-known component of a law passed by the Obama administration called the Fixing America's Surface Transportation Act. Now, that act gained notoriety when drafted because it permits specialty auto manufacturers to produce low-volume runs of new cars based on designs at least 25 years old without compliance with modern safety standards. The law was aimed at makers of classic car replicas like the Shelby Cobra and at the kit car industry. The whistleblower program has been unused until now, and it will pay Kim using part of the proceeds of the large Hyundai fine. It all worked out well for Kim, of course, but will this produce a stream of spurious complaints and office intrigue? Well, maybe, but from the perspective of an individual engineer, it seems to me that the ethics are fairly straightforward. If you work for a company that's doing something that is illegal, blow the whistle. If you work for a company that's covering up a defect or design flaw that has the potential to injure or kill people, blow the whistle. In this case, it was fairly cut and dry. Engine fires are dangerous. In most cases, however, the gray area is wide, very wide. If someone in your company intentionally alters your design to make your product less durable, do you blow the whistle? Now, in my mind, no, if the consequences of that change won't harm life and limb. Now, in the case of this legislation, that's the standard that NHTSA will use, safety. Of course, there are other things companies may do that break the law that are not safety critical. If you're aware of them, you are morally obliged to report them, but outside of engineering, who has sufficient knowledge to make that call? If you don't, then don't. Your conscience is always your guide, but it's important to avoid the tragedy of this engineer. Roger Beaujolais. Now, he was the Morton Thiokol engineer who uncovered the risk that low temperatures would pose to the space shuttle and recommended that the launch of Challenger on January 28, 1986 be postponed. That decision was overruled by senior level company managers, but unfortunately, Beaujolais was proved correct with the loss of 7 lives. Now, in this case, he did everything right. He investigated scientifically, wrote a report, sent a memo, solicited support of his engineering colleagues, and on the morning of launch, refused to sign off on the flight. But afterwards, he had to live with the inevitable sense of guilt. Could I have done more? Should I have done something else? Beaujolais was eventually awarded the American Association for the Advancement of Science Award for Scientific Freedom and Responsibility and became an advocate for engineering ethics, but he commented publicly that he was haunted by the Challenger disaster. Now, most of us will never be put in that position, thankfully. At least in the automotive industry, there's now a way for engineers to take that nuclear option and go to the regulator if absolutely necessary. But before you go down that road, your primary ethical consideration is to do anything you can to keep it in the family and act internally first. Talk to trusted colleagues, investigate scientifically, like Beaujolais did. And if that doesn't work and lives are at stake, pull the trigger. It may be career-altering or career-ending, but in the long run, you'll be glad you did. Well, that's it for today's episode of End of the Line, brought to you by engineering.com. If you like this show, be sure to subscribe to our channel and click on the notification bell for our next episode. For our deeper engineering video series for the manufacturing professional, visit engineering.com TV to watch exclusive shows like Manufacturing the Future, not found here on our YouTube channel. The link is in the description below. Thanks for watching.